how we can observe the BPSK waveforms over the CRO. So this channel one is connected with your bit pattern which you have applied, and channel two is with BPSK signal. Actually, on seeing this, you could not be able to identify there is a phase shift has occurred, which is 180 degree phase shift. So to observe that, we will be adjusting our knob, time domain knob, for one transition. Okay, see, observe here, there is a transition, but still we could not be able to identify there is a phase shift. So still I will increase the time domain, so you can observe here the phase shift. Okay, as there is a transition from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, you could be able to identify the transition like this, or sometimes it will be a center transition also. Okay, so now what we will do, see, this is of channel 2 signal, right? It is a time domain signal. Now we would like to see this time domain signal with respect to spectrum. So it is applied to channel 2, no? So I will be taking a channel 2 spectrum. Okay, for that, what these are the things you supposed to do. First, press map menu. Okay, so right now here channel 1, 2, all these options are there. Go with first one. Okay, here FFT should be there. Right now the channel 2 spectrum it is, but I want channel 1 spectrum it is, but my output PSK signal is connected to channel 2, as of which I will change it to channel 2. Okay, so you could be able to see the spectrum like this, but here the analysis becomes very difficult, as of which we have to do some changes or some modifications. So what is the first step? We will adjust this to the center of this display. After that, I will press zoom, so you can observe here. Okay, so after pressing zoom, you could be able to see the spectrum in this way. Okay, so then actually after this, what is your next step? Next step is to deal with adjusting the bandwidth. So for that, we will move on to the cursor button, and we will press that cursor. Okay, so just a minute. Okay, now it is off. Actually, how to make frequency cursor amplitude time. So connect, take the type to frequency and then mat. Okay, so cursor 1, cursor 2 are there. Okay, whatever the two cursor point, this is one and this is another one. Okay, so right now this is dashed line, this is solid line, so cursor 1 is selected. So I will use this knob to fix the cursor location. You can observe, you can fix the cursor location at this point. Okay, next, so from this the peak is starting and peak will end. So at the same location, I have to adjust my cursor 2. So to adjust my cursor 2, I will be pressing cursor 2, and I will be using this knob to make this vertical line to be shifted. So you can observe, I will take this to the minima. See, these two should be at same location. Okay, so I will be still adjusting it. So these are the, this is a minima before the peak and this is a minima after the peak. So this is how we can adjust our bandwidth. Okay, two cursor for observing the bandwidth. You can observe here, so delta hertz and delta dB both are available here. So this is my bandwidth for a particular BPSK signal.